telling me things I should already know, but my ways are too hard to let go. To me, it's okay, and all of your sins will be gone if you just trust and obey. Oh, trust and obey. Try to hear what I say and do it my way. Hey, trust.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, this morning. We're so grateful again this morning as we come to you in prayer. Father, we just thank you right now. We just give you all the glory and praise. Father, we are truly grateful today. But this is the day that you've made, Father. We're rejoicing this morning. We're glad in it, Father. We give you praise now. Thank you that you have brought us to this very, very moment. Hallelujah. Oh, we give you glory this morning, for this is your day, Father. This belongs to you. We say thank you, Lord. For it's in you that we live, move, and have our being. Thank you, Father. Thank you for another day, Father. Thank you for your presence this morning, Father. We gather in your holy presence this morning. He said, if two of us come together, two or three gathered together in your name, you would be in the midst of us. So we thank you for being in the midst of us this morning, Father. for you are worthy of all the glory and all the honor. We thank you. So, Father, we thank you for bringing us into this brand new day and giving us another chance, another opportunity to be your vessels, Father. Thank you for it. Truly loving us. Thank you for being sovereign, being Lord. You are Lord of Lords, King of Kings, Father. And so you are in a place all by yourself, Father. There's none like you. There's none beside you. There's none like you, Lord. And so when we're coming into prayer, we're coming to our Heavenly Father, to our Holy Father. We're coming to Abba, Father. So we thank you that we're able to pray, that we have the privilege of prayer. So we're able to adore you. We're able to thank you. We're able to give you praise, to give you glory, to give you honor, Father. We're able to talk to our Father. So this morning, we just want to say thank you. Thank you for the activities of our limbs. Thank you for rest in our bodies, Father. We thank you for protecting us throughout the night. So we just want to say thank you. We want to thank you for being in our right minds this morning. Thank you for bringing us into this time of prayer. For you have told us to be in prayer, to be a people of prayer, to pray without ceasing. So we thank you as we come together in agreement this morning. As we thank you together this morning, Father, as we give you glory together this morning, as we come on one accord, I say, Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah. We praise your name this morning. For it's in you that we live, move, and have our being. So, Father, you are our creator. We're your creation, Father. So you, our sustainer, you are our redeemer. You are our God. And so, Father, you have called us to trust and obey. You've called us to do that, Father. So this morning, as your children, as being a part of your kingdom, Father, as vessels of yours, Father, we come before you this morning to reaffirm our commitment to live according to your will. So this morning, Father, we recognize that trusting and obeying you is the path to true peace and fulfillment. So, Father, today let us understand that your word teaches us that obedience is better than sacrifice. And that faith without works is dead. And so this morning, Father, we desire to walk in obedience to your commands. And we're trusting in your promises and relying on your strength this morning. And so, Father, we pray that you will strengthen us, that you will give us what we need today, mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, Father, that we would obey your word, that we would trust you. So this morning, we know that there are times when we struggle with trusting you fully, Father. And so being transparent, there are times where our faith wavers, and we feel uncertain about the future, Father. And so this morning we ask that you pour out your spirit this morning upon us. Strengthen our trust in you this morning, Father, for we do not want to continue in a cycle. We do not want to continue in the wilderness, encircling in the wilderness for years and years and years. So help us this morning to remember that you are a God who keeps his promises. And you are faithful and you are true God. And so teach us to trust in your timing, Father, and your ways, even when we don't fully understand. So this morning, renew our spirits, Lord, hallelujah. Renew our spirits and ignite a passion within us to trust you in all things, to obey you in all things. And so, Father, we thank you for another chance. Oh, Father, we ask that you would forgive us for wavering. Forgive us for not obeying, not trusting. For you have called us, you set us apart, that we might be the light of this world, that we might be the salt of this earth. And so, Father, we ask that you would strengthen us today. Thank you again for another chance. We have been given a new mercies today. We have been given new mercies. Hallelujah. You are God of another chance, and we thank you for that today. And we praise your holy name. We give you glory. We give you honor right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you, for your love is true, God. And each day is a blessing, Father. So we thank you for the privilege of knowing you this morning. And we thank you for being known by you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for the relationship we have with you through Jesus Christ. And so, Father, we're so grateful this morning that we can come boldly to the throne, to your throne of grace. Hallelujah. Confident this morning that you hear us and you answer us. So we thank you for the ways that you have shown us, shown your faithfulness to us. Thank you for the many ways you've shown your faithfulness. The times that you have provided when we didn't see a way. Hallelujah. How you would use a stranger to be a blessing to us. Oh, we thank you for the times that you have provided. Thank you for healing us, Father. Thank you for guiding us and comforting us. Thank you for walking with us. Even when we were alone, Father, you was with us. Even when we didn't have anyone, you comforted us. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you that we're a friend of yours this morning, Father, that you're that close to us, that you are with us always. So we give you glory this morning. We give you honor, Father. Thank you for your goodness today. So we praise your name today, Father, for this day belongs to you. And as your vessels, we desire to glorify you. We desire that you get all your glory today, Father, in us and through us. So, Father, don't let us take your glory. Don't let us do things for vain glory. Don't let us do things for pats on the back, but let us do it unto you, Lord. Whatever we do, let us do it unto you this morning. Let us be truly surrendered to you as your vessels. And this morning, Father, we ask that you will search us as we're praying, as we're believing today, as we're trusting and obeying today. Father, we ask that you will search us. Search us, oh God, even now, today, Father. Oh, God, if there's anything in us that's not like you, Father, we ask that you would take it out. Show us today that we may be transparent, that we may be open and honest with you, Lord, and open and honest with ourselves, Father. So today we ask that you would show us anything that we need to do today, Father. Anything that we need to reprioritize today. Anything that we need to remove from our lives, Father. Let us not just go through the motions, but let us be mindful of what it is you desire for us to trust and obey you, Father. The things that you desire to be moved or reprioritized in our lives. So we thank you for rest this morning, that we are refreshed to get in prayer, to pray, to call on your name, to bring every petition, every concern to you, casting all cares upon you, Lord. So we know the enemy desires to sift us. And he comes to steal, kill, and destroy us. But you said that you have come that we might have life and have it more abundantly, Father. So we thank you for what you're doing in our lives today. So you brought us to this place, to this time of prayer, Father. And so we want to give you glory. We want to honor you in all that we do. So this morning, we trust you. We speak it, Father, that we trust you. That's what your word says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Hallelujah. And lean not on our own understanding, but in all of our ways, acknowledge you, and you would direct our path. And so this morning, Father, we're acknowledging you. We're coming to you, Father, and say, you lead the way. You guide us today. We trust you. Not only trusting you, Father, but we obey you. We trust that you will lead us. And we obey, Father, where you're taking us. We're following. What you have us to do, we are obeying. So, Father, let us be mindful of the words. Let us be mindful of our thoughts. Anything that is not of you, we cast it down. That we bring our mind to the obedience of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, let us be mindful of our thoughts and our words today, the words that we speak, for we know that life and death is in the power of the tongue. And so, Father, let us be mindful of what we speak. For you have given us authority. You have given us dominion in the earth. We know that power, we have the power as we speak into the atmosphere. So this morning, let us be mindful of our word. Not only our words, Father, but also our actions today. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we thank you that we're able to slow down just a little bit and hear and listen to the Holy Spirit. That you give us wisdom, that you give us discernment. You give us guidance. So we thank you for that today, that we're sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit. We're not in a hurry, but we're able to slow down. Hallelujah. And allow the Spirit to guide us today. You told us to be, even now, Father, you told us to be slow to speak, but quick to listen. So as we're listening, we're getting clarity. Hallelujah, we're getting understanding. So we praise you for that this morning. We thank you. We thank you, Father, for hearing us and hearing our cry this morning. Thank you for what you're doing in our lives. We thank you for your word this morning. As we're reading your word, we are not only reading, but we're studying it. We're meditating on your word. For your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light to our path. So we're taking your word today and we're allowing it to guide us. Your word is leading us. Your word is speaking to us. And so we thank you for that this morning. David said, I take your word and I hide it in my heart that I might not sin against thee. And so this morning we take your word and we apply your word to our lives. Hallelujah. And so, Father, we thank you that we're not caught up or consumed with the things of this world. We know that you're going to take care of our needs, and we thank you for that today. That we might continue to trust you and obey you, Father. You said no good thing will you withhold from us who walk upright. So we thank you. It's in the humility we live in this place, because you have empowered us to carry out. You have empowered us. Your word said that you have given us everything we need for this life in godliness. So let us be intentional. Hallelujah. For you are truly worthy today, Father. We're grateful to be your vessels. We're grateful to be your children. Thank you for choosing us. Thank you for drawing us, Father, to be in your kingdom today. Let us not worry. Let us not stress. Let us not be unstable. Let us not be double-minded today, Father. For your word says a double-minded person is unstable in all their ways. And so today, Father, we choose you. And we will trust you and obey you. Thank you for the peace that you give unto your children. Hallelujah. So, Father, we know that that causes us to be quiet, to not speak as many words and not to be all over the place, but it allows us to be led by the Spirit. So we thank you for that today. So even as we're closing in this prayer, Father, we thank you that we commit to worship today. We commit to worshiping you and praying, that we have a lifestyle of worship. Hallelujah. All of our worship, we commit to you, Father, in our lifestyle, that we surrender our will to your will. And worship is dying. We die to ourselves. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That we are led by the Spirit, that we do not gratify the lust of the flesh. And so we kill off our flesh, that we may worship you. That we may worship you in true worship. But your word says that we're presenting our bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto you, which is our reasonable service, which is our proper worship. So this morning we offer true worship to you. And we praise you on our jobs, in our homes, in our workplaces, wherever we are today. We offer worship. Hallelujah. Hey, God, we worship you today. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. And we praise your holy name today, Father. We give you glory. Worship. I hear you saying, they that worship me, hallelujah, must worship in spirit and truth. So let us worship you today in spirit and truth. Not to be seen, not to be heard, but to give you what's due to you, Father. For we were created by you, for you. So today we give ourselves back to you. Hallelujah. And we say your ways are higher than our ways, and your thoughts are higher than our thoughts, Father. So today we surrender. As Jesus said, if you are my disciple, take up your cross and follow after me. So today, Father, we thank you for that clarity and that understanding, that we deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow after Jesus. Yes, we're trusting you, Lord, and we obey your word. And we praise your holy name today, for this day belongs to you. We love you, Lord. Every need is met, every way is made, and we give you glory. Let your peace be amongst your children today. Wherever we are, wherever we go, your peace shall abide. And we praise your holy name. and we give you glory. It's in Jesus' mighty name we pray, and we say thank God and hallelujah. Amen.